We did it, guys. We won another game jam. Another one to add to the pile. Today, we're going to learn how to win every game jam you enter. To illustrate this, we'll be using my latest winning jam submission to Bar Jam as a case study. First, read and follow the rules. If you can't do that, your chances of winning are as good as the chances of EA not putting microtransactions into the next FIFA game. For this particular jam, the rules were pretty straightforward. Only work on the game during the jam, it had to be safe for work, and it had to use the theme of suspension. Come up with a unique idea based around the theme. You might want to make a reskin of Flappy Bird, but fitting the jam theme around a pre-existing game idea is boring. Use the theme to come up with ideas that provide unique and fun gameplay and can be completed within the timeline of the jam. For this, I thought of playing as a student who's attempting to get suspended from school. I don't know of any games where this is the objective, and no physics destruction is pretty fun on its own.
I am attacking!
So, it checked the unique box for me. Get a gameplay loop set up as soon as possible. If you're not familiar with a gameplay loop, it's basically just a way for the player to continuously play your game. I figured the fun for this game would mostly come from destroying stuff, but you'd have the incentive to replay if there was a score, which for this game I called demerits to keep with the theme. To complete the gameplay loop for this project, I needed to get a character that could attack and do damage to accrue points, an AI teacher to chase the player, a score screen, and a replay button that would reset everything. Decide early what you want to focus on for the jam and allow yourself to cut corners with the other stuff. This is especially the case if you're working alone. Depending on the length of the jam, you're probably not going to have time to create from scratch all of the music, sound effects, graphics, 3D models, scripts, and still have time for polish. For this project, I decided to use Kate Lausberg's 3D assets as a base and only model stuff when I needed it. And despite having decided that from the very beginning, I had to model way more than I initially thought I would, so plan on that happening to you too. And I also decided to use sound effects and music from packages I had previously purchased. If your game jam doesn't list the objectives on the overview page like mine didn't, consider reaching out to the game host to see if they're willing to let you know. I didn't, and it almost cost me. I didn't originally plan on adding any sound, but on the last day, quickly threw some in. Turns out there was a music and sound design category I didn't know about. Finally, make a test build at the end of every day and have it available for other people to test and give feedback. Beware, most people won't want to play your half-finished game.
I'm not going to subject myself to another 20, 30 hours of this mess.
That's completely okay, because making builds every day will also help keep you focused on building things for your game that matter. When my day 3 build in this 7-day jam still didn't have a gameplay loop, it was a wake-up call that the next day needed to be 100% focused on completing that. Then, from there, just work as hard and with as much focus as you can to finish on time. Play other submissions, review them, and learn from how other people approached the same problem. Try to be helpful, and above all, have fun. I know this whole video so far has been about how to win a game jam, and that might be the only reason that you're here. And I'm sure that there's at least one Jared in the comments who's written,
"Game jams aren't about winning."
So if you see any of those, make sure to reply with a Jared Tech W. But honestly, they're not wrong. Being entirely focused on winning really misses the point of what jams are all about. Yeah, game jams are meant to challenge you, and it can serve as a great motivator for pushing yourself and getting something done in a short amount of time.
Nice shot!
Don't let that get in the way of your other responsibilities, relationships, and health. Your primary focus in a jam should be to learn, grow, and finish something you're proud of. Chances are, winning a game jam isn't going to bring you Blackthorn Prod levels of fame and fortune. In fact, on the day my game was announced as the winner of the Bar Jam, it achieved a whopping 0 downloads on itch.io. but that's completely fine because it's immeasurable to what I learned during the jam. I made an entire system for damaging and breaking things, an equip system where players can pick up different weapons. I made destroyable items that have a chance to drop random loot. I made doors that can be opened, closed, locked, or broken. I made scene transitions and an AI system. And as a real treat, I got to see people play and enjoy something I put into the world.
Dude, come on, Pete. Seriously, Aya, let's nerf this guy on the next patch, huh? What is he, on a Segway? What's his backstory? I know you gave him a backstory. 1989, 1890 Olympic world sprinter. World record for the United States in the 4x4, the 40-40 dash, or what here? Later, finesse, doesn't know what to do. The fastest runner, the most athletic person you'll ever see in the game, can't open the door. Papega head.
That kind of stuff is invaluable. So, you know what? If the Flappy Bird recreation is really what your heart is set on, go for it. You might not win anything, but what truly matters is that you had fun and enjoyed the process. So good luck in your jams.